guys. It's Tyler from Team Ghoul Rennie. I don't know about you guys, but I'm getting really sick of watching all of Will's stupid celebrations on every goal he scores. So I thought today, I teach all you goalkeepers out there how to dive properly so we can save all of Will's weak-ass shots and never have to watch him celebrate again. So let's get to it. Okay, so for a good early progression for the low collapse dives, it's gonna be just starting on your hip right here and just have a server a couple yards away. I'm just gonna roll the ball out to him, pop up, go back down once he hits it, and all you have to focus on is just getting your body weight forward, attacking the ball, hand on top, hand behind. That's all you guys have to worry about doing this. So it's gonna look like this. And you just, when you roll it back, make sure it's easy service for him to hit one touch, and then he can start stretching you out a bit more and putting it wider once you feel more comfortable. And it'll just take your ground as you go. And for the right side, it's gonna be the exact same thing, just tacking out towards this angle. And this time the only difference is that your left hand's gonna be on top of the ball, right hand behind. Other than that, everything's the exact same. So you just roll it out, play it in, rock back up. And then once you feel more comfortable again, you start putting more pace on it. This is a lot of times how we warm up, even with professional teams. And all that really changes is just how hard the surface is hit. All right, so a very simple drill that you can do once you're ready to start with these dives from your feet is set up like this. And to start, we'll talk about what you want to do for a low collapse dive. So if you're working, diving on your left side, you want to start on the left side of these cones. And all you're going to do is slow them through little tiny steps through the cones. And while you're doing this, you want to be looking up at your server. You don't want to get stuck looking down at the cones, because when you're playing in a game, you're never looking down at your feet. You're always looking at the ball. So you're going to be going through the cones, little tiny steps, coming out, set. You're going to be set for about half second. And then the server is going to hit a ball low right along this red line through the middle of this gate right here. And what you want to focus on at this point is being low. Tacking with your left foot should be your first step towards the ball, and shooting both hands towards the ground. You don't want to get stuck in this chopping, waxing motion, because the ball's going to end up squeezing under you a lot of times. So you get set here, ball's going to be hit, step forward, point your toe, get low, and just shoot through it, just like that. Extremely comfortable doing mid-height collapse dives from your feet. A good progression is just start on your knees. Just makes everything a little bit easier. So all you need to do is just have a serve about 4 or 5 yards away from you, and they're just gonna toss in a service just about right in this range right here. So all you need to focus on is you just take a step with your knee out towards the ball, just like you would if you were on your feet. So here I'm picking my angle, it's gonna be right in line with the camera. And when the ball comes in, same thing you're focusing on, getting a hand on top of the ball, hand behind the ball, and landing on your hip, and make sure you're attacking forward. And really focus on pinning the ball to the ground. You wanna make sure that this hand is on top, so that way when you're coming from the air to the ground, it can't move anywhere. All right, working on the right side of this progression, it's gonna be very similar. The only difference is you're just gonna be stepping with your right knee tacking forward. Your left hand's gonna be on top of the ball. Right hand's gonna be behind the ball. Still landing on your hip, tacking forward. Pop back up, give the ball back to your server, and just keep working through it. So you hear this all the time with ever you're talking about keepers diving, bringing the ball from the other ground. It's always get one hand on top of the ball, one hand behind the ball. And this confuses a lot of keepers, but you guys gotta recognize it's actually the exact same technique as if, say, I'm receiving a shot straight in my chest. I prefer the W technique, where you got your thumbs touching each other. So when you're diving, all it is just a W technique. And when you dive, it's just rotated. So you can see my hands don't move at all. Still right here, diving, hand on top, hand on the side. So all it is just a W technique, and it's just the ball and your hands tilted at a different angle. All right, so this is how it's gonna look with an actual service in. So the ball's just coming low, tacking forward, get back to your same spot, hand on top of the ball, hand behind the ball, sure you really, you can start stretching out once you feel more comfortable. And that's all it is. Okay, so for when we're working on the mid-height collapse dives, it's gonna be the same start. This time I'll be working on the right side for the right dive. So I'm gonna start on the right side of the cones. Quick, slow them through, set. And once you're set for this, the difference is here is you're not just shooting your hands low because the ball's gonna be coming about in this range, but you really wanna focus on when you step to it is flexing this quad right here. You don't wanna be going down. You'll see a lot of times keepers' cleats will be showing like this and they're going down. And that way, you can already see how off balance you get. And if the ball's going high, you're just gonna be whiffing at it. If you keep this leg flexed right here, this quad, your right quad, your plant foot, if it's flexed, you can still push off for the high balls. You can still shoot low for the low balls. And ideally, when the balls hit right here, you want it to look really controlled and really flex your core when you're going to the ground. If you can, you want it to look as controlled as possible. That's the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure that you like, comment, subscribe, follow us on Instagram, and also go to goldremy.com and sign up for our newsletter. There's a bunch of content there that we don't put up on the channel, and so that's the only way to access it. So just do that. Like, just do it. I mean it. Do it. Like, now. Okay? Do-re-mi-fa-so-la.